We continue now at the top of Daf Samach Dalet Amud Aleph Masechta Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 64a. The Gemara just finished saying that when it comes to an item which is partially orig, it's partially woven, and partially a tachshit, partially an ornament. So the halacha is even a small amount is considered tameh. The Gemara brought a source, and the Gemara said that source is only by Tumas Meis. How do we know that it's true by Tumas Sheretz as well? And the Gemara here finishes off, Kli Kli Mehasam. It's learned out of Gezeirah Shava from the word Kli, which is written by both Sheretz and by Tumas Meis, and that's how we learn out that this halacha is true by Sheretz as well. The Braisa continued, Mosaf Sak Al Habeged Shetami Mishum Orig. The Braisa said that sackcloth has an additional feature over a normal beged because it is tameh as a woven item. So the Gemara says, Atu beged lav orig. That the whole statement doesn't make sense. A beged is also a woven item. So what do you mean to say that a sack has an additional thing that it's woven? So the Gemara answers, Hachikamar, this is what it means. Mosaf sack al habeged afa pisha eino orig tameh. The halacha by sackcloth is even if it's not woven, it's tameh. That's an additional feature to a regular beged. Lamai chazi. So what is this sack? What is it useful for in such a scenario? Rabbi Yochanan says, Shekein ani kolea shalosh nimin v'tola v'tzavar bito. A poor person can braid together three hairs of sackcloth. Again, it's made out of goat hair, and he can hang it around the neck of his daughter as a kind of a jewelry, and therefore it's considered to have a use, and therefore it is tameh even in that scenario. The Gemara now continues with a braisa. Tana Rabbanan, we learned in a braisa, sack ain li lo sack. I only know that sack is mekabel tumah. Minayin l'rabos es hakilkali v'sachavak. How do I know to include even the harness strap and the band that's used for the animal, that's also mekabel tumah? Talmud lomar o sack. Pasuk has an extra word o that includes even the kilkali and the chavak. What about maybe we should even include ropes and strings again that are also made out of the same material? They should be makabel tuma. Tamid lomar sak. The pasuk says sak. Masak tavoy va'orig. Just like sak is spun and it's woven. Af called tavoy va'orig. So too it has to be something which is spun and woven. And this would not apply to the ropes and the strings. The Braisa now continues. Harehu omer b'meis v'chol kli or v'chol maise izim v'gomer tischato. So by Tumas Meis, it says any maise izim, anything made from goats, you have to purify it. L'rabos, it's a kilkli and it's a chavak. That also includes the same items. Kilkli and chavak for Tumas Meis, just like Tumas Sheretz. Yochol shani marbes achavol and mesamashichos. Again, the same thing. Maybe by Tumas Meis, I should include these kinds of ropes and strings. V'dinhu. And we should say it's learned out. Timei b'sheretz v'timei b'meis. We know that there is Tumah by Sheretz and Tumah by Meis. Ma'akesh Timei b'sheretz lo Timei ela Tavei v'Oreg. So just like by Sheretz, it only applies to Tavei and Oreg. Afkesh Timei b'meis lo Timei ela Tavei v'Oreg. So too, when it comes to Tumas Meis, it's only going to be Tavei v'Oreg. Essentially, they're going to be the same. We will not include the ropes and the strings by either one. So then the Gemara, the Braisa questions, Hein im Hekel b'Tamei Sheretz, shi kal anokel b'Tumas Meis shi chamura. Why should we say there's a din over here? Why should we say there's a direct limud? We know Tumas Sheretz is more lenient than Tumas Meis, so maybe by Tumas Meis we should be more strict, and we should say even items like strings and ropes should be mekabel tumah. Tamid lomar beged v'or l'gzeir shava. It says the words beged and or both by Tumas Meis and Tumas Sheretz. Nemar beged v'or b'sheretz v'nemar beged v'or b'meis ma beged v'or ha'amor b'sheretz lo timei l'tavei v'orig af beged v'or ha'amor b'meis lo timei l'tavei v'orig. So the Gemara says it's a gzeir shava, and therefore again it's going to apply only to the kilkli and the chavuk. We are not going to say the chavolim and the meshichos are mekabel tumah. And the Braisa continues, Uma beged v'or ha'amor b'meis tamei kol maise izim. Just like beged v'or by meis, all things that are made from material from goat hair is considered mekabel tumah. Af beged v'or ha'amor b'sheretz tamei kol maise izim. So that's also true when it comes to sheretz. Ein li eladavar habamin izim. So at this point, I only know it has to come from the hair of a goat. Minayin l'rabos davar haba miznaf hasus miznaf hapara. How do I know that even materials that come from the tail of a horse and the tail of a cow should also be mekabel tumah? Tamid lomar osak. So the Gemara now learns it out from the same pasuk before of osak. That includes not only regular typical sackcloth that's made out of izim, it would include even the znav hasus and the znav hapara. But the Gemara asks, v'apikse l'kilkali v'chavak, didn't we use the pasuk of osak way earlier in the beginning of the Braisa for Kilkli and Chavuk? So the Gemara says, no, hani mili mekame delesei gzeira shave. That was before we had the gzeira shave. Hashda da'asi gzeira shave ayasar le. Now, once we have the gzeira shave that essentially compares directly Sheretz to Tumas Mei, so we already know Kilkli and Chavuk, that it's mekabel tumah. We don't really need Osak, and now Osak includes the Znav Hasus and the Znav HaPara. V'ainli Elo B'Sheretz. I only know Znav Hasus and Znav HaPara from by Sheretz. B'Tumas Meis Minan. How do I know B'Tumas Meis? Again, Osak is only written by Sheretz. V'Dinhu. Again, the Gemara says we should learn it out directly. Tumah B'Meis V'Tumah B'Sheretz. We know there's Tumah by Meis and Sheretz. Ma'kesh Tumah B'Sheretz. Also, Davar Haba Mizonav Hasnus or Mizonav HaPara K'Maisa Izim. Av Kesh Tumah Meis. Also, Davar Haba Miznav Hasus or Miznav HaPara K'Maisa Izim. It should be identical. Just like we say by Sheretz, it's Tumah so too by Meis, it should be Tumah. The Gemara says, no, hein im hirba betumas erev, shehi meruba nirba betumas shiva shehi muetas. Just because we say that it applies to tumas erev, tumas sheretz is only one day that you need to become tahor. When it comes to tumas meis, which is a seven-day purification process, we should maybe not include so many things. Taman lomar beged v'or l'gzeirah shava. Again, the Gemara, the Brisa comes to the same gzeirah shava, beged v'or, nemar beged v'or b'sheretz, v'nemar beged v'or b'meis. It says beged v'or by sheretz, and it says beged v'or by meis. Ma beged v'or ha'amr b'sheretz. Also, davar haba mizonav hasus, mizonav hapara, kemaisa izim, ha beged v'or ha'amr b'meis. Also, davar haba mizonav hasus, mizonav hapara, kemaisa izim. Again, the same gzeirah shava, just like when it comes to sheretz, we say it's tame, so too when it comes to tumas meis, we're going to say that if it comes from a sus or from a para, it is going to be tameh. The Gemara now says, umufna. This gezeirah shava has to be used using free words, words that are extra, meaning the words beged and or are extra. Dilav mufna ikal mifrach, because if it's not free words, if they're not extra words, there's a pircha on this gezeirah shava. Ma'al sheretz shekein metame b'chadosha. A sheretz has a certain stringency that it's metame even as small as a lentil. So who says you can learn from Tumas Sheretz to Tumas Meis? So therefore it must be an extra word. And the Gemara says, la'ayef nuye mufne, which of the sides is extra, meaning is the beged v'or that's by sheretz extra, or is the beged v'or by tumas meis extra? The Gemara says, mechdi sheretz iskish l'shech vazera. Well, let us see. We know that sheretz is comparable to tumah by shech vazera. Dichsiv ish asher teitzi bimenu shech vazera, v'samich le'ish asher yiga b'chol sheretz. It talks about becoming tummy through shech vazera right next to the pasuk, talking about sheretz. Uchsib be shech vazera, and already says by shech vazera, v'chol beged v'chol or asher yelov shech vazera. So beged v'or, the cause of rachmana b'sheretz, lamali, it already says the words beged v'or by shech vazera. So what do you need beged v'or when it comes to sheretz? Shma mino alafnuya. You see, that's an extra word, and therefore we can make a gezera shava, and there's no ability to ask a pircha on the gezera shava. The Gemara says, v'akati mufna mitzad echadu, but isn't that only free on one side? Hanicha l'man domer mufna mitzad echad l'meidin vein meshiv, and that's good according to the one who says that you just need to have the term on one side of the gezera shava to be extra in order not to refute the gezera shava. El l'man domer l'meidin meshiv in ma'ikal l'meimer, but according to the opinion that holds, you need to have both sides, otherwise you can refute the gezera shava. D'meis nami afnuye mufnas. The Gemara, so ma'ikal l'meimer, what are you going to say? So the Gemara answers, d'meis nami afnuye mufna. When it comes to mace also, it is a free term. Mechdi mace iskish l'shech vazera, because mace also is comparable to shech, is compared to shech vazera. Dechsiv anogea b'chol tmei nefesh o ish asher teitzi mimenu shech vazera. The pasuk says, you touch something which is tamei nefesh, or an ish that comes out from him, shech vazera, so it's compared. It says beged v'or by shech vazera. What do I need beged v'or by meis? Shma mino lafnui. You see that this gezeirah shava is mufna from both sides, and therefore there is no problem learning gezeirah shava one to the other, and that's how we know that even items that are made from zanav hasus and zanav hapar are makabel tuma. The Gemara now continues darshaning the psukim by the war against Midian. The pasuk says, "Vanakrev es korban Hashem, ish asher matza kleizav etzada vitzamid tabas agil v'chumas." The pasuk here is talking about the fact that after the war, the people took the spoils of war and they donated them, and it lists various kinds of kalim, various kinds of adornments which were donated. So Amar Rabbi Elazar, Rabbi Elazar says, what are all these items? So agil zed defus shel dadin. Essentially, agil will be a bra. Kumas zed defus shel beis harechem, and the kumas is an area, as again, it's an adornment that's used to cover the area of the beis harechem. So Amar Rav Yosef, so Rav Yosef says, yahachi, if so, haino demetargamin and machach. That makes sense why we're going to call, why the targum translates this kumas as machach, means davar hamevim lidei gichuch. It's something that brings to Rashi, says gichuch is like leitzanus, something that brings people to leitzanus. Amar le rabba, rabba said to migufei dekrosh ramina. You see even from the pasuk itself, kumas is like an acronym, kan makom zima. Here is the place of adulterous and licentious relationships. Gemara now continues at the two dots. Vayiksof Moshe al pekudei hachoyil. Moshe got angry at the soldiers. Amar Rav Nachman, Amar Rabba Baravua. So Rav Nachman says in the name of Rabba Baravua, Amar len Moshe le Yisrael. Moshe said to Klal Yisrael, Shema Chazartam L'Kol Kalchem Arishon. Maybe the reason why you're trying to bring a carbon, the situation over there was that they were bringing a carbon right around this time with the war against Midian as some kind of a kapara. So he said, did you do this? Did you do a similar sin to the sin that you did with the daughters of Moab? Maybe you had znus with the daughters of Midian. Rulo, they said to him, Lo nifkad mimenu ish. No, not every person is accounted for. Nobody has done a sin of that type. Amar Lahani said to them, Imkein kapara lamef. So what are you bringing kapara for? Amrulo, they said to him, Imidei aveira yatsanu, imidei hirhur lo yatsanu. It's true, we didn't do aveira, but that doesn't mean we didn't think about it. Miad vanakrev is carbon Hashem. That's why they brought this carbon to Hashem. Tana devei Rabbi Shmuel, they taught in the yeshiva of Rabbi Shmuel, Mepinei ma hutzruchu Yisrael sheba oso hador kapara, Mipnei, why did the Jews of that generation need a kapara? It was because, and the Gemara will continue with this discussion, and daf samach dalet amud beis.